Hello and welcome to China Pulse, where we take a look at the stories being spoken about on Chinese domestic news and social media this week. The most talked about topic on Chinese social media this week has been the death of rising pop star Yao Beina. The 33-year-old gained fame after she sang the theme tune of popular soap opera The Legend of Zhen Huan in 2012. Her popularity then skyrocketed a year later when she competed in The Voice of China. Just when things were going well for the singer, she was diagnosed with cancer that had spread to her brain and lungs. She'd already been previously diagnosed with breast cancer in 2011 and had a mastectomy. Her death at such a young age shocked people across the nation, and even searching for her name using China's biggest search engine, Baidu, caused everything to turn black and white in her honour. In other celebrity news this week, the famous Chinese singer Jay Chou finally tied the knot at the age of 36. The pop superstar from Taiwan married his 21-year-old model bride, Hannah Quinlivan, at a ceremony at Selby Abbey in England last Saturday. The wedding set Chinese social media site Weibo alight and turned the venue in Yorkshire into an instant tourist attraction for thousands of fans. Just hours after the wedding, Chinese netizens found dozens of wedding dresses with the same design appeared on Taobao, China's leading online shopping website. On Jay Chou's online post bar, fans were amazed by the awesome online shopping craze. Jay Chou is set to stay in England for the filming of his second English-language film, Now You See Me, which stars Daniel Radcliffe. Elsewhere, 11 officials in Shanghai have been punished over the New Year's Eve stampede that left 36 people dead and 49 others in hospital. Some senior political and police figures were removed from their posts, while others from tourism and public security have received disciplinary punishments. The families of the 36 victims have each received an official apology and 800,000 yuan in compensation each, equivalent to just over $131,000. Childbirth has become a hot topic with a series of stories this week. First was a story that went viral when a woman was found giving birth by the roadside in South China's Hainan province. Two women were spotted by the roadside, one with blood on her lower half. She was found to have already given birth, though the umbilical cord was still attached. Members of the public, as well as staff from a nearby drugstore, rushed to her aid, and an ambulance soon picked her up to whisk her to hospital. The mother and baby are both doing fine, and the baby boy was given the name Lu Sheng, meaning born on the roadside. Elsewhere, China's biggest tennis star Li Na has announced that she is pregnant. The recently retired tennis star announced the news at the opening of the Australia Open, where she won her second Grand Slam last year.
Me and Dennis, we are so excited. Our first child will be out of this summer. I think Dennis doing a good job. He just made one ace.
The 32-year-old says she's now looking forward to take on the next big challenge of her life, becoming a mother and housewife. Another story causing a stir on social media concerns a 13-year-old girl who threw a tantrum when her parents told her that they're having a second child. According to the Wuhan Evening News, the girl stopped going to school, refused to take exams, threw things, and threatened various forms of suicide until her mother tearfully gave in and terminated the pregnancy at 14 weeks. This sparked huge debate over China's spoilt generation of only children and how they control their parents. Last but not least, of course, the Chinese economy has been the source of much discussion, both in the news and on social media. The Chinese economy grew a respectable 7.4% in 2014, but that was below the government target of 7.5% and the slowest growth in almost a quarter of a century. On the whole, reaction online has seen people content with the way the economy is running and fully willing to accept what the government calls the new normal of slower and more sustainable growth. That's it for another edition of China Pulse. For more information on any of the stories mentioned, you can check out our website, cncworld.tv. We'll be back with another roundup of Chinese news next week. See you then.